This video is sponsored by Spider Holster. Spider Holster hand straps are my number one go-to camera accessory. Whether I'm shooting weddings, concerts, or sporting events, sometimes up to 12 hours per day. It comes in 7 different colors, including my favorite, brick red. Just look at that beauty. Get yours today at spiderholster.com. Quick story, I remember the first time I did the bridal show. It was 2016, and just on a whim, I decided to do it. It was about 6 weeks prior to the show that I signed up, so I did sign up late for the show. I remember the Monday before the show, one of the girls over at the company called me up saying that they had 800 registered brides showing up for the wedding, which I thought was great. I didn't know anything about the bridal show, so I thought on its own right there, that was awesome. We set up our booths on Friday here. The show is Saturday and Sunday. So when I got here that Friday, I remember one of the girls coming up to me and saying that they already had 1,300 registered brides, which I thought was awesome, you know. Next day, Saturday morning, I show up about 10 a.m. Girl comes back up to me. She says she has 1,900 registered brides. At that point, I'm just like, look, I mean, I'm already signed up. You don't have to sell me on it anymore. No problem. It was insane that first show. It was overwhelming. The amount of brides that showed up there, I couldn't even handle it. I had no idea what was coming at me. It was definitely overwhelming. At the end of the day, there was 2,700 registered brides that signed up for that show, which is insane. If you just get one or two brides to sign up, that pays for the show right there for you, for your booths. The other great thing about this show, about 3 to 4 days after the show, they send you an email list of all the brides. All those registered brides, 2,700 registered brides, that first show for me in 2016. And it averages right around there. It's anywhere between 2,700 to 3,500 emails that you get of the brides, and it's phenomenal. So we're gonna make our way in now. Okay, so two things not to do at a bridal show. First off, if you're a vendor, Friday we come in, we set up. About 4 o'clock, I leave and I make sure that the booth is fully set and ready to go for the next day. Also, candy jar was filled. I come back here this morning, the candy jar is down to this. If you're a vendor, do not do that. Bad move. Okay, now if you are a vendor and you've done the bridal shows before, you're gonna know about this one. You wanna have a nice booth, and in here I have a nice chair with the rustic wood floor, the fireplace, looks perfect, right? So if you are someone coming to the bridal show, don't sit in a vendor's chair in their booth. I have had people come in here, not so far this weekend, but about 5 to 6 times already throughout the years, that have walked in this booth and literally just sat down in this chair, put their bags down, got on their phones. Don't do that. Don't do that. And don't forget to stay tuned for my video next week, where I'm going to show you everything that I've gotten in this booth, where I got it, the pricing, any questions you might have, I'll answer all them for you. So that's in the video coming next week. Day one, doors just open. It is already slammed in here. I shoot about 100 weddings a year. From this bridal show since 2016, I average about 20 to 25 weddings just from this bridal show alone that I'm able to get. And also, I probably have about 3 to 5 signups the day of the bridal show.
Yeah, I do have a question.
Yes.
Would you go to Galloway, New Jersey?
Yes, I'm there like 100 times a year. No. What venue down in Galloway?
The Seaview Hotel.
Yes, yes. Okay. I was just there once this summer.
Okay.
Oh my God.
Beautiful.
Like, beautiful. I forget the girl that I worked with there, the maitre d' there.
Okay.
But just so many different, and she had the wedding outside in the back.
Yes.
Oh my God, it was awesome.
Okay.
Yeah,
cool.
So good pull on that.
Yeah.
Definitely a good pull. So girls, this is for wedding photography in the photo booth.
Okay.
Okay, we have a drawing right over here for a free engagement session you can sign up for. And if you girls all want to hop in the photo booth with the pups, you can do that as well. Okay? Any questions, let me know, okay, girls?
Hi.
What date were you getting married
July
on?
July 16th.
Of 2022?
Yep.
Okay, what's your venue at?
It's in Annapolis, Maryland.
Maryland, okay. Yeah. So there would be a little bit of a travel fee for that down to there. What's the venue in Annapolis?
It's the Crown Plaza Hotel.
Okay, how did you wind up getting that awesome date at that awesome venue? I mean, in July at that time,
yeah,
in Maryland.
Yesterday.
Are you serious? Maybe they had a cancellation or something, or?
I'm not sure, but she said she had it open, and we're like, well, may as well go.
Yeah. I mean, because most dates now at times, it's a year and a half to 2 years, you know? So to be able to get that date that quick, right, at that great of a venue, you know, you guys should be going down to Atlantic City after this and playing blackjack, because
you're
lucky.
That's actually where we're going for the bachelorette party.
Okay. Yeah, so that would be the pricing on that there.
Okay.
And that's for the two photographers with it.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes.
Can you order your photo booth separate from photography?
Yes, it doesn't have to be the same. Okay. It can be separate.
That's
okay.
Good. Thank
yes.
you.
Yes, have a good one. So what do you rent these out for, bachelor parties or?
I teach traditional style archery. So we teach, we host events. We do birthday parties, private lessons.
Really?
Base classes.
So show me how far back that, because that is really tight, ain't it?
Again, the stance, you know, you aim, you draw, take it tight, and then you let go. So.
Right. And you do, you have a lot of events and parties that they book for?
Yes. We have a lot
like
of.
Like the axe throwing, like that got so big for a while. I have not seen this. And when I was walking by this early this morning, I was like, oh, that is just the best idea ever. That's just an awesome idea. It's the first time I saw it. That's just awesome, man.
Thank you.
Awesome, brother.
All right, man.
Be safe, okay? Day one in the books was incredible. Probably the best bridal show that I've been to so far. Normally, I have about 3 to 5 signups over the weekend. In total, 5 signups today already. Fantastic. Looking forward to day two. I'll be back tomorrow. The Philly Bridal Show is sponsored by ACS. It is the only bridal show that I do throughout the year for 2 reasons. First, it is held off season in January, which makes a huge difference. I don't have to take off during the summer, during the busy months. Second, the place is always packed. Beginning to end yesterday, mobbed. Brides everywhere, friends everywhere. On average, I book 3 to 5 on-site contract signings for the weekend and about 20 to 25 overall signups from the weekend. Just yesterday alone, I had 5 on-site contracts signed, which is incredible. Today, looking to do the same. Day 2 has been insane. We've only been open for about an hour so far. It's been mobbed in here. There's been some crazy freezing rain outside that I thought was maybe gonna keep people away. No, it is insane here today, awesome.
So we already, for the Times Square one, we already have engagement photos done?
Yes, so what you would do in that case is, the engagement session is $250, so you would just take the $250 off of that price. And even if you decided you wanted one of the other packages that have the engagement session, you know what I mean? Time-wise or anything like that, you would just take the $250 off the price.
Okay, yeah, perfect. Yeah.
When are you getting married? What is the date?
December 16th.
Of 2022?
Yeah.
Okay, and where at? What's your venue?
I don't know yet.
Okay.
That's sad, I know.
No, that's okay. At least you got the date. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You're trying to just get that together. Girls, how are you? So this is for wedding photography in the photo booth.
Okay.
We have a drawing for a free engagement session you could sign up for. And if you girls like, you can also hop in the photo booth as well. Okay, any questions, let me know, okay? You can go on like Shutterflies and all that kind of stuff, make your own, or you could just have like the professional ones made where we send them out to get made and everything. So yeah. But no, they are expensive. They can run, I mean, on an average, they probably run $1,400 to $1,700.
Wow.
Let's just say here that you have the 8-hour package.
That's what I want to use.
Yeah, so whatever you want to fit into that 8 hours, you would just fit that into there. So if you're getting married at a hotel, then we might go
to... No, we're getting ready at the hotel.
I'm sorry. If you're getting ready at the hotel, then we might go to the ceremony at a church. Then we might go to the park. Whatever. Anything in that 8 hours is
where we...
Okay, we'll go wherever you need to go.
Ready at the hotel, and then the ceremony and the reception is at one place.
Yes. Okay. So you would fit that into the 8 hours, because when you get ready at a hotel, as a girl, you want to give yourself about an hour to an hour and 15 minutes for the getting ready shot. That is a wrap, guys, on day 2. We're just about finished here. 4 more contract on-site signings today. That makes 9 total over the weekend. $18,000 brought in, and that is just from this weekend alone, not including all the brides that are going to get in touch with us throughout the next few weeks looking for dates. Huge success. It was packed today. I thought it was going to be a little slow because of the rain out there.